How to Be a Hero by Cat Weldon, read by Saffron Coomber. Chapter 1. The Cup of Krud.
Tonight, we feast. Tomorrow, we fight.
The enormous man, big enough to be two normal men but average-sized for one Viking, raised his drinking horn high into the air. Ale slopped out of it and rained down on those sitting around the rough wooden table. Another man raised his hand.
Who are we fighting? Because we're not technically at war with anybody right now.
The enormous man paused, his red face screwed up in thought.
How about tonight we feast, tomorrow we go on a nice picnic?
The other Viking continued, mopping ale off his head with his sleeve.
I like picnics.
No, it's supposed to rain tomorrow,
replied one with tufty hair tied back in pigtails.
What about tonight we feast, tomorrow we pick our toenails?
Ha! After eating Ethel's cooking, it should be, tonight we feast, tomorrow we have toxic turnip breath,
croaked a voice from the back. Several people grumbled in agreement, then ducked as Ethel threw a ladle across the room. A Viking with a dark, brushy beard climbed ponderously to his feet and silenced the room with a loud burp.
Tonight we feast, tomorrow we have an ultimate shin-kicking contest.
This suggestion received an enormous cheer. The air filled with ale foam and half-chewed food as cups and plates were tossed towards the rafters. Unnoticed by anyone, a pale, scruffy boy put down the tray he carried and ducked out of the door. The boy's name was Whetstone. It wasn't a very good name, and he didn't like it much, but it was all he had. Outside, the cool air tickled his white skin, making the hairs on his arms rise. Whetstone pulled his thin cloak around his shoulders and stepped away from the door. Cutting through the wispy clouds above him hung a bright yellow moon, giving him just enough light to see by. Behind him in the great hall of Krud, the Vikings were still cheering. Whetstone had only been in the village for a couple of days, having managed to blag a job in the kitchens. It hadn't been hard. There wasn't exactly a queue to help clean up after Viking feasts, and trying to get grease stains off the ceiling was a nightmare. All Vikings were the same, finding any excuse to guzzle and gorge all night until their already pink, blotchy faces grew pinker and blotchier, and they all fell asleep under the table. Whetstone gazed up at the moon and grinned. They wouldn't be celebrating when they found out what his real plans were. A deathly white hand dropped onto Whetstone's shoulder, and his heart jumped into his mouth as he spun around.
Oh, Valley, it's you,
he sagged with relief. The taller boy nodded at him.
Come on, you know he doesn't like to be kept waiting.
He released Whetstone and headed away from the great hall, finding his way easily in the darkness.
I couldn't get out earlier, Whetstone skipped after him. I'm supposed to be working at the feast. I saw the cup, though.
Valley grabbed hold of Whetstone's tunic. In his free hand, a knife gleamed.
I know Lightfinger thinks you're the one who's going to take it, but remember, I was here first.
He gave Whetstone a little shake.
You're a nobody. We felt sorry for you, that was all.
The boy released Whetstone's tunic.
Once you have the cup, you give it to me, understand?
Whetstone brushed himself off. It was impossible to imagine that Valley, this boy with dark, sunken eyes and almost translucent skin, had been the one to convince him to leave home and join the thieves. It seemed unimaginable that he had been nice once. With a final look behind him, Valley led the way out of the village and moved towards a nearby thicket of trees. A flickering light appeared. It was the thieves' camp. Whetstone followed Valley towards the firelight, tripping as his two large boots caught in unseen rabbit holes and clumps of rough grass. They stepped into the circle of light. A shabby-looking man with overly large front teeth glanced up. the long wooden staff he used to support a damaged leg lay by his side.
Did you see it? On the shelf next to the fireplace. Chief Awfulric always likes to display his treasures during feasts. The man spat into the fire, which spluttered green for a moment.
Whetstone nodded slowly, thinking of the golden cup studded with jewels he had seen while collecting plates.
Lightfinger, are you sure it has to be me that steals it?
I'm doing this as a favour to you, Whetstone.
Don't you want fortune and glory?
The ratty-looking man probed.
Or would you rather scrub porridge out of the pans for the rest of your life?
Valley dropped onto a nearby tree stump and sniggered.
Yeah, you might as well get used to thieving. It's not as though you're going to turn out to be a hero, are you?
Watch out, Valley. If you carry on like that, Whetstone will think you don't like him.
Valley gave Whetstone a pained smile, the blade still in his hand, twisting easily through his fingers. Whetstone shifted awkwardly, his eyes fixed on the knife.
It's not the boy's fault you failed to get the cup, Lightfinger snarled.
He turned back to Whetstone.
You're not going to fail me, are you, Whetstone?
I know this is your first big theft, and it's natural to feel nervous, but you'll soon get used to it.
He hasn't got the guts for it, Valley scoffed, picking at his nails with the dagger. Let me have another try. It's only a cup, after all. No, Lightfinger snapped. You had your chance. This is Whetstone's job now. It's taken me years to track down that cup, and I'm not leaving Krud without it.
Valley stabbed the knife into the tree stump and leaned back on his arms, his expression hidden in shadows.
It's only a shame I can't take it myself. Alas, I am too recognisable, too well known, too...
Slow?
Valley dodged a blow from Lightfinger's staff. Whetstone dug his nails into his palms.
If I take it, you're sure I'll be famous?
The man nodded.
More than your wildest dreams.
Whetstone sighed. He had some pretty wild dreams. In his heart, he knew he didn't have the skills to be a great warrior. He could hardly lift a sword and preferred running away to fighting. He would never make it as an explorer due to chronic seasickness. But a thief? That was a possibility. He was quick and sneaky, and no one seemed to notice him much. When Valley and Lightfinger, the greatest thief in all the known world, had arrived in his village, and Valley suggested Whetstone join them, it had seemed too good an opportunity to miss. People loved telling stories of Lightfinger's exploits. If Whetstone could steal great treasures just like Lightfinger, then people would know his name and sing stories about his fantastic adventures too. Then he would be a somebody. And being somebody, even a thief, was better than being nobody. All he had to do was steal Awfulric's stupid cup, and then he could be part of the thieves' gang for good.
Mind you, the life of a celebrity isn't everything it's cracked up to be,
Lightfinger sighed.
All the autographs signing and people trying to kiss you. You're just a kid. You don't want to be worried about that.
Whetstone felt his cheeks burn.
You'll never get a minute's rest. Everywhere you go, it will be, Whetstone, tell us about the time you...
Well, never mind that. You haven't actually done anything yet, have you?
The boy bit his lip. The thought of returning home to the village of Drott as Whetstone the Sly or Whetstone the Cunning, anything instead of Whetstone the Nothing, made his head buzz. But at the same time, he felt bad about stealing from Awfulric and the Vikings of Krud. They had been quite kind to him, really. He hadn't even had too many chicken bones thrown at him during the feast. Lightfinger seemed to sense Whetstone's doubts. Using his staff to lever himself upright, the crooked man got to his feet. He loomed over Whetstone, who was treated to a lovely view right up his nose. A large, knobbly bogey hung there, glinting in the moonlight. He wrapped his arm around Whetstone's shoulder.
I've been keeping an eye on you, Whetstone, whenever I dropped into Drott over the years.
Lightfinger smiled.
I knew you were going to be very useful to me one day.
Valley tossed something into the fire behind them. The flames fizzled. Whetstone remembered his life in the cold, grey village of Drott and shuddered. He had lived there with his foster mother, Angerbother, or the Angry Bogey, as he secretly called her, in her rescue home for orphaned wolf cubs, Dunhowlin. She had taken him in after he turned up suddenly in the middle of the village in a basket. No one knew where he really came from.
"I still think it's a mistake," Valley said from the shadows. "The runt will only mess it up."
Lightfinger snarled, his ratty teeth casting odd shadows on his face.
"Be quiet, you."
He turned back to Whetstone. "Valley doesn't understand. He's not like us. The cup is the key." Lightfinger often said that.
"The key to what, though?"
"To you joining us, of course," he said quickly. "Don't you want a place to belong?"
He gave Whetstone's shoulder another squeeze.
"Remember what I told you. The cup is magical. It can tell us many things. Things that will make us famous.
Us?
You, of course. The saga of Whetstone and the magic cup. Oh, I can hear it already."
Whetstone narrowed his eyes. Lightfinger was desperate to get his hands on Ulfric's cup. It was all he talked about. He claimed it could tell fortunes.
"I still don't understand why you picked me to do this."
"Call it my master thief instincts. That cup will unlock an amazing future for you, but first you have to hold it in your hands. I don't take just anyone on as my apprentice, you know. After all, I am the greatest thief in all the known world," Whetstone recited.
Lightfinger squeezed his shoulder again, his grip painfully tight.
I know," the boy muttered.
"I have taken the jewelled crown of Queen Helga of the Iron Fists," Lightfinger continued, his eyes bright with past victories, "plundered the famed pearl of the Mer people, and picked the pockets of kings, queens and princes," Whetstone finished.
He liked hearing these stories, almost as much as Lightfinger liked telling them.
"My thefts are a way of adding a little spice to the boring run of days. What is life without a twist or turn along the way?"
Whetstone's fingers wound the edge of his cloak into knots.
"Don't you ever worry about getting caught?"
Vikings were not kind to thieves. If Ulfric caught him, Whetstone would probably be marooned on the barren islands to be eaten by the wild beasts who lived there. Or maybe Ulfric would force-feed him mouldy toenails until he choked. Or worst of all, perhaps Whetstone would have to hand-wash the skid marks out of all the Viking underpants in the village. Fame and fortune were all very well, but you had to be alive to enjoy them. Lightfinger released the boy's shoulder and moved away.
"Maybe Valley's right. Maybe you're not brave enough."
He scratched his stubbly chin with the top of his staff. The silvery snakes that decorated it sparkled in the moonlight.
"I suppose I'll just have to take you back to Drott."
"No way. I'm not going back," Whetstone said stoutly.
If the price of leaving the Angry Bogey was taking Ulfric's cup, well, Ulfric would just have to get another one.
"I'll get the cup. And the glory too."
"Excellent!"
Lightfinger clapped him on the shoulder. His mouth curved into a cold smile.
"Like Valley said, it's only a cup. Then it's off to the great city of Cloggybum, and minstrels will be singing songs about us before nightfall."
Watching Whetstone pick his way through the darkness back to the great hall, Lightfinger turned to the older boy.
"You should go after him. Keep an eye on our dear little orphan. We can't afford any mistakes now. Not when we're so close."
Valley spat into the long grass at his feet. Lightfinger grabbed him by the arm and peered into the boy's face.
"Only a few days more. 12 years of planning just for this moment. Soon I'll have all the power I ever dreamed of. The boy gets us the cup. The cup gets us the riddle.
And when we've got the riddle, we won't need the boy anymore."
Lightfinger released Valley and smiled.
"Something like that."
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.